Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Fatouseghir. So today I made this dish called Gras. If you want to see how I made this, keep watching. Please like and subscribe for more deliciousness. Here I have the ingredients for seasoning the fish. This is cilantro, parsley, pepper, garlic, some cube maggi, the shrimp one, and I also have the small cubes. I don't really know what they call this one. Green pepper. You want to cut the fish in big pieces because you're going to be stuffing it with the seasoning. Also, for the fish head, I love fish head, so I like to split it so it will season really well. Now let's blend all the seasoning together and stuff the fish with it. So I'm going to put all these ingredients in the blender and blend it all together. Actually, this is a food processor, so it's better with a food processor because you don't want the seasoning to be liquid. I'm going to add some pollo seasoning and black pepper to the mixture. Here I'm going to be wearing gloves because this seasoning is really hot because I have hot pepper in there. So I'm going to add some myself, it's fine to be alone. Here I have onions, garlic, so we're gonna blend all that together. And this is what it would look like. We're gonna move on to our green onions. We're gonna cut them in small pieces before putting them in the blender. Now we're gonna move on to the green pepper and the red pepper. So I try to be cute with it for you guys and cut it with a knife, but listen, the African in me is too strong, so I have to finish it up with my fingers. Now we have tomatoes. We're gonna cut them and add it to the mixture. I love the color of fresh vegetables. Playing with my mind, gotta get out of here tonight. Oh, I wanna run off, I am flying. I changed my pot to a pot that actually sticks this time, and I transferred the frying oil to that pot after filtering it. And now I'm going to add all the seasoning that I blended, the onion, the garlic, the parsley, and the tomatoes and green peppers and red peppers, all of them to the pot. And now we're going to I'm going to add spicy brown mustard. I personally like that one, but you can add Dijon mustard too if that's what you have. Now I'm going to add the leftovers from the fish stuffing with the parsley and stuff to the pot. I'm going to add the cube maggi and the crevette cube maggi that I have shown you earlier. I'm now going to add the pollo seasoning. I love this seasoning. I literally put it on everything that I cook. Like, it's the most used seasoning in my kitchen. Now we have black pepper. I love black pepper. I like spicy food. Mix it all together and let it fry. Make sure to continuously keep stirring the mixture because you don't want it to like burn under the pot. Because I'm using a non-stick pan. I mean, not a non-stick pan, the opposite. So I have to keep stirring frequently. We are now going to add all our vegetables. So that was eggplant, yucca, potatoes, sweet potatoes, pumpkins, and now we're going to add carrots and cabbage. We're gonna add water to that mixture and let it boil until the vegetables are ready, and then we'll add the fish to the water and let it boil. While all that is cooking, we are going to clean our rice and steam it. So I'm using the jasmine broken rice. We're going to clean it really well until the water is somewhat clear. We're now going to drain the water completely out of the rice before putting it in the microwave. The fish and the vegetables are now done, and we're going to remove them all from the soup. They were smelling so good and so flavorful at this point. Empty hearts and neon lights, they're playing with my mind. Gotta get out of here tonight. Oh, I wanna run off and fly. Now I'm going to add some boiling water to the soup. This part you don't really have to do, but I had to do it because I didn't have enough soup left.
I'm going to sprinkle,
but if you do, you don't have to
seasoning.
Add water. This is black pepper and the pollo seasoning. Not a lot, just, you know, to refresh the flavor.
A good rule of thumb
bit.
Is that you want the rice to be at the same level as the soup in the pot. Bring me back to where we started.
We're gonna mix it in really well and close the pot to let it cook and steam really well. What I like to do is add some paper towel to the top of the rice to help it steam. It helps keep the moisture in, so that way the top part is steaming as well as the bottom part. Oh my god, guys, look how well that rice is turning. Oh, don't you just want to dig in? But we're gonna flip it like this and make sure the top and the bottom are cooked the same way, and then we're almost ready to serve. And I tell myself it's fine to be alone, just to find somewhere. Okay, so now this is an extra step that you don't have to do, but my family loves it, so I do it. This is called the sorrel leaf. So you're going to boil this, and then you're going to turn it into a paste. I would usually blend it, but I was too lazy to do that, so I just did it this way. You're going to make sure you put it in the paste as much as you can. You're going to add some of your cooking juice to it.
To boil pepper to add instead of the pepper sauce. Add some sumbara. And we're gonna now mix it all together. I'm now going to add okra to the mixture. Now you don't have to do this, but we like to do it this way, so yeah. Add some lemon juice to make it extra sour. Et voila, you have your sorrel sauce.